I'm delighted to be joined by Laurence Robertson, who's of course MP for Tewkesbury. Not much going on at Westminster, so Laurence has kindly joined us here today at Cheltenham for our Racing to School Day with Bournside School. Laurence, I mean, you've had a small glance at some of the programme that Racing to School does with young people. Why do you think it's so important to connect young people with our wonderful sport?
Well, I'm delighted to be away from Westminster for a couple of days because of this fantastic race course, which, although it's called Cheltenham Race Course, falls within my Tewkesbury constituency. Always got to get that point in. But I think it's really important to engage young people, really, in any sport. I think sport is absolutely wonderful for young people. I was so involved in sport, all sorts of sports, when I was youngster. I think it's really, really important to get them involved. And I think particularly with racing, because it doesn't get as much publicity as maybe football or some of the other sports, and yet it is a fantastic sport. There's so much involved with racing. I mean, there's obviously the sports side of it, there's the discipline side of it, there's the looking after animals side of it. There's so much involved, so I think it's a really great initiative.
Well, we appreciate that, and we're delighted that next year that the all-party group, which you're co-chair, is going to be supporting a Race to School. Tell us a little bit about the parliamentary group and why that's such an important and enthusiastic group.
Well, the all-party group is involved with MPs and members of the House of Lords, and we hold various meetings, perhaps each month, with figures from horse racing. But what we also do is every year we hold a charity racing dinner in the House of Commons, and we try and raise money for a charity. We've been doing this for about 10 years now. We've raised an awful lot of money thanks to people who have come along, people who have bought tables, people who have donated auction prizes, raffle prizes and all the rest of it, and those who have come along and bid for them. So thanks to all those people, we've raised a huge amount of money over many years for charities, and we're delighted to be working with your charity Racing to School as we go forward. It's probably going to be at the beginning of July next year, so we hope to raise a sizable amount of money so you can continue your good work.
Well, we very much appreciate that. It's a bit like Westminster now, because we're being barracked by the PA system. We'll keep going for a moment. I mean, part of really the progression in racing is the Racing Together initiative, which brings together all organisations, charities and commercial bodies that engage with their local community. And that, you do that for a living, of course, but I mean, it's absolutely vital for racing. I'm sure you'd agree that racing, you know, is a force for good, and shows that that it does really give back to its communities.
Well, absolutely. I mean, Cheltenham Racecourse particularly, it's not just the people who work at the racecourse. Of course, when we hold meetings here, it has a huge knock-on effect throughout the whole community in terms of the hotels and clubs, pubs, restaurants, taxis, shops and all the rest of it. It's a magnificent event, particularly at the festival in March, of course, which we're always building up to. It's a great, great event. But across the country, there are many, many different events like that in horse racing. Horse racing takes place, I think, virtually every single day of the year, apart from Christmas Day, I think he's correct. And that generates money, generates jobs in the environments where it takes place. We've got, I think, about 59 race courses, have we? Throughout Great Britain, fantastic network of sport throughout the country. Marvellous.
Excellent.